Hello students, in today's session we will discuss about two topics from the lesson hydrosphere. The two topics are oceans and relief of the oceans. So let us start the first topic, oceans. Oceans are large water bodies. The crust of the earth is uneven and the low basins are filled with oceans and remaining parts are continents. So these are known as first order landforms or primary divisions of the earth's crust into oceans and continents. So we have to remember that continents and oceans are the first order relief features of the earth. Now the geographers have divided the oceanic part of the earth into five oceans, namely Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Southern Ocean or Antarctic Ocean, and the last Arctic Ocean. These are the five oceans. And coming to the one more word, sea. The sea is often used interchangeably with ocean, but strictly speaking, a sea is a body of saline water partly or fully enclosed by land. You can observe the difference on the picture. See the difference. Sea, it is a smaller area compared to ocean and it is partially enclosed by land, whereas ocean has no boundaries and it is very large part comparing to sea. So that is the difference we have to remember when we are using the words sea or oceans. Now see the table. In the table you can observe five oceans. See the first ocean, that is Pacific Ocean. It is separating Asia and Oceania. Oceania, it comprises of Australia, New Zealand, Papua New Guinea together from the Americans. So overall, Pacific Ocean is separating Asia and Oceania. Second ocean, Atlantic Ocean. It separates America from Europe and Africa. Coming to third ocean, Indian Ocean. It washes upon Southern Asia and separates Africa and Australia continents. Fourth one, Antarctic Ocean or Southern Ocean. It is the extension of Pacific, Atlantic and Indian Ocean and it encircles Antarctica. Fifth ocean, Arctic Ocean. Sometimes it is considered as a sea of the Atlantic, which covers much of the Arctic and washes upon North America and Eurasian parts. So these are the five major oceans which we have to remember. And one more interesting point here, Panthalissa. It means millions of years ago, oceans were combined together. That means all the oceans, all the five oceans were combined together. And that single super ocean was known as Panthalissa. The same thing we can observe in the picture. That blue color, it comprises of complete five oceans area, which was previously called as single super ocean or Panthalissa. And the major oceanic divisions are defined in part by the continents, various archipelagos also. Here archipelago means group of islands. Islands, already you know the meaning. Island means four sides it covers with water. So here archipelago means nothing but a group of islands. So this is our first topic, oceans, about the oceans. Now we'll go for our second topic, relief of the oceans. The ocean basins are in many ways similar to the land surface. That means whatever the different types of landforms we can observe on the land, the same differences we can observe in the ocean also. There are submarine ridges, plateaus, canyons, terraces found within the oceans. So overall, ocean floor is divided into four parts. Those four parts are continental shelf, continental slope, deep sea plain or abyssal plain, and the last one, oceanic deeps or trenches. So these are the four parts of the oceans. Now we'll see the first one of the relief of the ocean, continental shelf. It is the border zone between land and sea, and it extends up to a depth of 200 meters, and it occupies about 7.6% of the total ocean area. The continental shelf is that part of the continental margin which is between the shoreline and shelf break. The largest continental shelf is Siberian Shelf. It is in Arctic Ocean, and the depth and the width is 1500 kilometers. Next, this region is important for fish wealth, crude oil and natural gas. Even we can build seaports in this place only. So this is about continental shelf. So just see the same thing in the picture. First we'll see the coast. This is the coastal line, and from here the border in between continental slope and this line, this part is continental shelf. Next we'll see the second part, that is continental slope. Continental slopes are the regions of the steeply sloping seafloor that lies between the continental shelf and the deep ocean basins. Continental slope is spread from 200 meters to 3000 meters depth. It comprises of 15% of the total ocean area. These slopes are formed by the process of erosion of glaciers and rivers. Submarine canyons have also been observed in this region. The continental slope boundary indicates the continents. This is the important point. So let us see the picture now. The first part we have completed, continental shelf. After that, the slope, the red color marked area you can observe, that slopy area, that is called as continental slope. So it is in between continental shelf and deep sea plains. Now we'll go to the third part of the relief of the ocean, deep sea plains or abyssal plains. Deep sea plains are gently sloping areas of the ocean basins. These are the flattest and smoothest regions of the world. Oceanographers believe that abyssal plains are so flat because they are covered with sediments that have been washed off the surface of the continents for thousands of years. Because of these reasons, this area is completely smoothest region. The depth of the deep sea plain varies between 3000 to 6000 meters, and it covers about 76.2% of the total ocean area. So let us see the picture of deep sea plains or abyssal plains. Here once again we can see all the three completed parts: continental shelf up to 200 meters, continental slope up to 3000 meters, and deep sea plains from 3000 to 6000 meters. This red colored round of area is abyssal plains or deep sea plains. That means it is in between the continental slope and oceanic trenches. Now we'll go to the last part of the relief of the ocean, that is oceanic deeps or trenches. These are the narrow trenches that plunge as great ocean deeps. That means it is the deepest area from the ocean. They typically form in locations where one tectonic plate subducts under another. So they are very significant in the study of plate movements. Already we know that plate tectonics theory. One plate pushes or moves from one place to another place. It extends up to a depth of 6000 meters and more. Most of the deepest trenches are not located in the midst of the ocean. They are found close to the continent. Atlantic Ocean has few short trenches. Trenches are long, narrow and very deep, while most are in the Pacific Ocean. That means the deepest trenches we can find in Pacific Ocean. 57 oceanic deeps have been explored so far. That means as per the studies, we have observed 57 oceanic deeps till now. Now we'll see the picture of oceanic deeps. The same picture, this the last part, the largest, the deepest place is nothing but oceanic trench. So this is about our topic, relief of the ocean. And we'll see one more table. Just now we have completed ocean deeps or trenches, no? So here we have a list of trenches. First one, Challenger or Mariana Trench. It is located in Pacific Ocean. Its depth 11,022 meters. Second one, Puerto Rico or Neves Trench. It is located in Atlantic Ocean. Depth is 10,475 meters. And the third one, Java Trench. It is located in Indian Ocean. Depth is 7,450 meters. So this is our today's topic completely. Thank you.